The world and the general public was stunned by the breakdowns, fatal breakdowns, of both Union City and Prairie Bayou in this year's Preakness and Belmont Stakes. Now, we haven't had a fatality in a Triple Crown race since 1959. But still, it raised questions and concerns, ones we brought up to two outstanding veterinary equine surgeons, Dr. Larry Bramlage of Kentucky and Dr. Nat White of Virginia. We start with a look at the horse's anatomy.
Well, the normal anatomy, the fetlock joint, which is the shock absorber of the horse's limb, is held in this 45-degree angle by the sesamoid bone and what we call the suspensory apparatus. When the horse fractures the sesamoid bone, that suspensory apparatus is disabled and the fetlock joint collapses to the ground.
But the breakdown becomes life-threatening when the blood supply is cut off to the leg.
Well, there's only two arteries to the lower part of the limb, and most of the time both sesamoid bones are broken when the fetlock joint collapses, as has happened in the two recent injuries. When that happens, if both arteries are gone, there's no blood supply to support repair.
At the internationally recognized Marion DuPont Scott Equine Medical Center in Leesburg, Virginia, Dr. Nat White talked about the emotions involved when a horse has to be put down.
It's a very difficult decision for a veterinarian to go and look at a horse and give a suggestion that they be put to sleep or that there's a certain type of surgery that may or may not work. It's not an easy decision, and no one takes this decision lightly at all.
Horses are bred to run. They are naturally competitive in the field and on the racetrack. Dr. Bramlage now shows us the biomechanics of the horse running.
Well, a horse runs on a lead leg in front, meaning that most of the weight comes down, landing on that single limb that carries the horse over stride to stride. That's a very efficient way of moving rapidly, but it puts a lot of load on that lead leg.
That load on just one leg is approximately 10,000 pounds, roughly 10 times the horse's body weight. Even with these anatomical shortcomings, fatal breakdowns are actually very rare. A 19-year study of New York racing revealed that less than 0.2% of the over 400,000 starters suffered a fatal injury. And in the last two decades, the progress in reconstructive surgery on the racehorse has turned a 90% mortality rate into a 70% chance of survival.
Well, the principal approach is once the sesamoids are fractured and the support system is destroyed to the back of the ankle, what you have to do is eliminate the need for that support system. So we do it by using bone plates and screws, bringing the ankle back up to its normal position and holding it in that position with internal fixation. That then gives the horse a pain-free limb to walk on.
But the surgery is just the beginning of a recovery process that is much tougher for the equine athlete than it is the human athlete.
These horses are not used to lying down. In fact, they can't lie down for very long. It physiologically is impossible for them to stay down for long periods of time and do well. We can put some of these horses in a sling, and there are instances where that works, but there are, again, different personalities. Some horses won't accept that.
No animal is better cared for than the racehorse. Precautions for their safety include two pre-race vet checks. But everyone in this industry is aware that even more needs to be done to protect the equine athlete.
I think that we can look to safer racing, and I think it will take a united effort with the industry to research this problem. Look at the racetracks, look at how the horses run, look at how they're trained, and I think with that kind of information, we can reduce these injuries significantly.